Dear students, today we will discuss internet multimedia streaming as another very important application of the internet. So first we need to understand what is streaming. Basically, transporting audio and video across the internet in real time is known as streaming. And Netflix, which is a video provider or audio provider in USA, has claimed in 2015 that their users have streamed 42.5 billion hours of videos. And in first quarter of 2018, 7.5 million new users have joined Netflix. And Netflix and YouTube normally consumed half of the bandwidth of the whole internet of the world. So this is such a big, important challenge to actually streamline videos and audios over the internet. And you also might have noticed that, for example, whenever you are using your phone, so whatever text you are sending somewhere or receiving emails, so that is not a very heavy thing. However, whenever you start using video downloads or audio downloads, so your net limit is basically vanishing very fastly. So how such content will be distributed? So there are different strategies. One is known as unicast, n-unicast, multicast, and on-demand streaming. So unicast is basically has an application in internet radio station. One sender is sending to one receiver is basically studied under the unicast. Then if we say n-unicast, this means that single sender is involved with multiple unicast, and it is challenging for the server and its neighboring systems, as they should also help the server to transport unicast multiple times. And then there is a peer-to-peer. Once a peer has received some video recording or audio recording, then that peer is sending that video recording to the next peer. So this means you have basically distributed the load between peers, and it is basically very good as compared to an unicast, in which server and its neighboring systems remain very busy. Then there is a multicast strategy as well. So this is distribution problem to the internet routers. So this means you are basically relying on the routers, and you are giving or distributing videos to routers, and then those routers are making sure that where those videos should be distributed. So in this sense, the functionality of routers has been extended beyond their normal workload, and it has been implemented in small networks in some private settings. However, it has not been realized to be implemented in the internet, because it is an overload to the normal load of routers. Then very interesting thing is the on-demand streaming. So end user view multimedia on their own time preferences. They want to rewind the videos, they want to forward the videos, and so on. So to serve millions of users worldwide from one server, so they have build basically content delivery network. So group of servers, and they are distributed strategically. So what does it mean? That help to support the streamlining task to neighboring devices. And most of the cases, this is available in access ISP. So this means that whenever you want to rewind or forward your video, so that would be that server in the content delivery network will be available to your local access ISP. And then there is another concept known as Anycast, that is basically the main realization of content delivery networks, that it enables an end user to automatically connect to the closest server, whatever is available to that particular user. So if we summarize today's topic, we have learned about internet multimedia streaming, what is streaming, what is unicast, ncast, multicast, and on-demand streaming supply. And then we have learned about content delivery networks and anycast.